Good morning to all. This is Professor Jayan Modi welcoming the entire batch of SE Electronics and Computer Science Semester 3 for the subject Electronic Devices, abbreviated ED, with the subject code ECC302. In today's video lecture session, we continue with unit number 1.2 by taking the topic of diode clampers. It is a part of the original module number 1 titled PN Junction Diode and Applications. Before we go into the topic, the contents or the syllabus for module number 1 as shown had two units, 1.1 as well as 1.2. We had earlier covered unit number 1.1 by studying the PN junction diode structure, the construction, the symbol, operation under zero bias conditions, forward bias conditions, reverse bias conditions, avalanche breakdown, characteristics, and the temperature effects on the PN junction diode operation. We also looked at unit number 1.2 that dealt with the application of a PN junction diode as a clipper circuit. In this particular video lecture session, we will be focusing on the second part, clampers. Moving further, the prerequisite knowledge required is a very good understanding of semiconductor physics, which all of us have studied way back in semester 1 in the subject Engineering Physics 1. Apart from that, it is my sincere request to all that in case if you have missed the previous lecture before this, lecture number 3 for module number 1, diode clippers, the first half of unit number 1.2, the YouTube video link as well as the QR code are both given there. So it's my sincere request to all to kindly go through it. Starting with today's topic, diode clamper circuits. Clamper circuits are used to add or fix a DC level to an AC input signal for obtaining a pulsating DC output signal. Now, the major difference between AC input signal and a pulsating DC output signal is that whereas an AC signal is alternating, it has one half cycle above zero, positive, and it has one half cycle below zero, negative. But for a pulsating DC signal, the entire signal cycle is either above zero, that is positive, or is below zero, that is completely negative. The only thing similar between an alternating AC signal and a pulsating DC signal is that both are continuous functions of time. So, the main job of a diode clamper is to add a fixed DC level to an AC input signal, because of which you actually either restore the DC level or you insert the DC level. Since clamper circuits usually add or append a separate DC level to an already existing AC input signal. From the point of view of the structure, diode clamper circuits contain a PN junction diode, resistor, and they also contain a capacitor, something which was not present in the previous section of diode clippers. You can also have a reference DC voltage as a optional circuit element. Please note that this particular reference DC battery voltage can be either positive, designated by plus Vref, or it can be negative, designated as minus Vref. Clampers can be mainly classified into positive clampers or negative clampers. This is completely based on their direction of the input AC signal to be clamped. So if you want to add a positive DC reference value, you need to go for a positive clamper. But if you want to add or append a negative DC reference value, you need to go for a negative clamper. The second category of classification is bias clampers as well as unbiased clampers. Now these circuits actually let you control the amount of the DC shift or the amount of the DC level which can be added to the AC input signal. This can be controlled by adding a reference battery voltage external to the circuit. The voltage can be positive, that is given by plus Vref, or the voltage can be negative, given by minus Vref. So if a clamper is said to be a bias clamper, then it can have a negative or a positive DC reference voltage plus minus Vref. However, if a clamper is an unbiased clamper, then it does not have any DC reference battery voltage present. Before we actually move on to the different circuits in diode clampers, their operating principle, how they work, etc., we'll use a similar point in which we had taken the operation of diode clippers in a slightly animated way. This, I believe, will help you understand the actual operating principle of diode clampers in a very simple manner. My assumptions are same. We have a similar alternating signal or an AC signal as in the earlier case of diode clippers. Here I've drawn a triangular waveform because for me, this is actually very easy to animate. So here I have a periodic alternating AC input signal in the form of a typical triangle wave, having its own time period and having its own frequency. The first diode clamper system which I will be taking up is an unbiased positive diode clamper. If you see the name, unbiased, this clearly means that there is no external DC reference battery voltage source present. And when we say positive diode clamper, it will clamp the entire AC input signal positively above the zero baseline. So if this alternating signal is passed through a diode clamper, the resulting output waveform will look something like this. Now compare the shape, compare the size, and compare the axis. What you find is that the shape is exactly the same. Unlike clippers in which you were actually distorting the input signal waveform by cutting an entire portion of it or cutting the entire signal cycle out of it. However, clampers do not have such actions. The shape of the output signal waveform is exactly the same as the input signal waveform. The only difference here being that is you can now see that above the zero baseline, you have a huge DC bias or you have a huge DC level actually added to the AC input signal. So whereas the AC input signal here was completely alternating, the positive half cycle was above the zero baseline, the negative half cycle was below the zero baseline. Here what you see is that the output signal is a positively pulsating DC signal, because although the signal remains continuous at each and every point in time, however, it has a DC level added to it, which makes it a positively pulsating DC output signal. We can have a similar logic for an unbiased negative diode clamper. Here, when the input signal is passed through an unbiased negative diode clamper, as the name itself clearly gives it away, negative, we have the entire signal is completely clamped below the zero baseline. So this makes it a negatively pulsating DC signal because the signal is continuous at each and every point in time. However, the variations are only below the zero baseline. So for the AC input signal, you are now able to add a negative DC level so that the output AC signal now becomes completely negatively clamped. We can also have a category of bias positive diode clampers. The reason being that we should be able to control how much clamping action do we want. So if we take the first case, we can have a diode clamper circuit which is biased work in this particular configuration. So what we see here is the signal appears to be positively clamped, but it is not completely positively clamped because it has a small segment of the negative half cycle going below the zero baseline. So this is what I call as a partial clamping action. And this partial clamping action can be easily adjusted by changing the reference DC voltage level. Similarly, you can add the additional reference DC voltage level to clamp the AC input signal a lot more above the zero baseline. So from the output signal that we see, although there is a substantial DC bias or a DC reference level added, you also have an additional jump by adding an external DC reference voltage source as a typical battery, so that the signal is still clamped deeply into the first quadrant above the zero baseline. A similar logic can also be applied for a biased negative diode clamper such as this case. From this animation, once again, although it appears that the signal is negatively clamped, you can still append a battery or a DC reference voltage source to ensure that a small portion or a small part of the AC input signal slightly goes above the value zero. This completely depends upon your applications. So here we are having a biased negative diode clamper. This small part of the AC input signal is clamped above zero, and we can have in a similar way the AC input signal clamped deep into the negative part that is below the zero baseline. This is quadrant number four. So although the original clamping action gives us a very high amount of DC level, you are further adding a negative DC level and you are clamping the circuit deep into the negative half below the zero baseline. So this is a simple introduction to the clamping circuit's principle of operation. If you compare this with diode clipper circuits straight away, you will notice that firstly, the signal waveform or the signal wave shape is not distorted at all as compared to the previous case. And here, the signal is completely continuous. Clippers had either a positive or a negative half cycle completely removed or partially removed. But clamper circuits do not clip or do not cut the AC input signal in any way. They only change the reference DC bias level above zero or below zero. Before we actually start with the different types of diode clamper circuits, I will make a similar assumption which I had made for a diode clipper, in which for all the circuits shown, I will assume that the input signal waveform is a periodic triangular waveform such as shown over here. Definitely, it will have a certain time period, it will have a certain frequency because the signal is ultimately periodic. It has a maximum positive value given by plus Vm and a maximum negative peak value given by the minus Vm. So the total peak to peak value is twice Vm. This signal is purely AC because the half cycle alternates above the zero baseline and the other half cycle alternates below the zero baseline. So needless to say, the average value taken over the entire period is zero because both are exactly equal halves. With this input signal with us, let us take a look at the very first unbiased positive diode clamper. This is the circuit diagram. The configuration is very much similar to a typical clipper circuit. Now, the only difference being that, one, you have a capacitor present always in a diode clamper as compared to clippers. And secondly, if you are able to recall, clipper circuits were either shunt or they were in series. For series clippers, the diode was connected in series with the AC input signal. But for shunt clippers, the same PN junction diode was connected in parallel across the terminals where the output signal was obtained. Hence, we got the name shunt. But for clampers, it is a mandatory configuration for all the PN junction diodes to be connected strictly in a shunt configuration across the terminals where we want the output signal to be obtained. Taking a look at the first circuit, the unbiased positive diode clamper, the output waveform looks somewhat like this. Before we even see how the waveform comes like this, get this fact straight. It is an unbiased positive clamper, so you do not see any mention of a reference DC battery voltage here. Since it is a positive clamper, the entire AC input signal, which is for us triangular in shape, having a positive peak of Vm, a negative peak of minus Vm, the entire signal has been shifted to above the zero baseline. So here we are easily able to see that the peak-to-peak value, which was changing from plus Vm to minus Vm, is now exactly between plus 2 Vm and the values zero. Now, looking at the circuit operation, let us see what happens. Before every positive half cycle for any AC input signal, the previous half cycle will be definitely negative. So our operation understanding comes from there. During the previous negative half cycle, the diode D will become forward biased with the voltage across it as shown. Reason being that when you are having a negative half cycle, the topmost part becomes negative and the bottommost part becomes positive. And since it is an AC input signal, capacitors easily allow the AC input signal to pass through them. So this negative potential comes over here, the positive potential comes over here. The diode cathode has a negative charge, the diode anode has a positive potential. The diode is clearly forward biased based on our understanding of the diode PN junction operation. So when we have the diode being forward biased, it will simply act like a short circuit as shown here. When the diode is acting like a typical short circuit as shown, you have a current flowing through this entire loop. Here, resistor R becomes completely redundant, immaterial, because of a short circuit placed across it. So here you have both loops combined into a single loop through which current flows in an anti-clockwise manner. When this particular current flows due to the input signal negative half cycle, this will charge capacitor C with the left plate negative and with the right plate positive. This is something similar to the fact that it can be imagined the whole AC input signal is technically applied across the capacitor itself. And the capacitor will charge to the maximum peak level signal of the AC input, which is given by the value Vm. So here, the voltage across the capacitor Vc will be exactly equal to Vm. And since due to the fact that the capacitor charges up to a peak value Vm, you have the output voltage Vout equal to zero, reason being that both the terminals are positive or both have the same potential. Since Vout is nothing but the potential difference between these two terminals, you have the potential difference given as zero. So during the negative half cycle, when the capacitor C charges and it will charge to a maximum negative peak value of Vm, you do not have any AC output signal obtained across the PN junction diode. Now, when we have the positive half cycle appearing in the next phase, we have the topmost terminal is now becoming positive and the bottommost terminal now becomes negative. So we have a negative going below here and a positive part going on top. This makes the entire PN junction diode now reverse bias because the cathode is given a positive charge while the anode is under a negative charge. So the diode is acting as an open circuit. It does not allow any current to flow through it. So here we have resistor R coming into the picture and the voltage obtained across it is given by the value Vout. The signs are as given plus on top, minus below. And to understand what is the signal value of the output signal Vout over here, we have one complete loop as shown and we can easily analyze this using the Kirchhoff's voltage law, which we have studied way back in semester 1, BWE. So, applying KVL over here, I'm going for a anti-clockwise direction. So, if you look at Vout and in an anti-clockwise manner, the last sign is plus. So, I have plus Vout over here. I then take a detour right into the circuit and across the capacitor. The voltage across the capacitor is given by Vm. Left plate is negative, right plate is positive, and since my direction is anti-clockwise, the lastly occurred sign minus Vm will be coming over here. I then go towards the AC input signal Vin. The top part is plus, the bottom part is minus. The last sign encountered is negative, so I have minus Vin over here, and again going back towards the output signal, the loop is complete. So we have Vout minus Vm minus Vin is equal to zero given by Kirchhoff's voltage law. We are just transferring Vm and Vin from left hand side to the right hand side. This gives us Vout is equal to Vm plus Vin. Since the maximum peak value of the input signal Vin is actually Vm, maximum positive peak, we have Vout is equal to Vm plus Vm. Vout is equal to twice Vm. So earlier, where the maximum positive peak signal value of your input waveform was Vm, we now have the value over here as twice Vm, and this is easily shown by the output AC signal present over here. So this part gives you twice Vm and this part gives you Vm. You are obtaining a DC pulsating or a positively DC pulsating output signal for an AC input signal applied to it. This is the actual working of an unbiased positive clamper, in which the clamping action is purely due to the capacitor only present in the circuit. If the capacitor was not there, it could not charge to a voltage level of Vm, and this voltage level of Vm already present during the previous half cycle would not have added itself with the incoming AC input signal peak value. Thereby, it was not possible to get a peak signal value for the output twice its original input signal value. One trick which I want to share with all of you into basically remembering how to plot waveforms for various clamper circuits as we go by. The trick is to look at the diode direction. Here, the diode is pointing upwards. The anode is below, the cathode is on top. As I had already discussed with you, the triangle symbol indicates direction of current flow, because current for a PN junction diode can only flow from anode to cathode. So if you are given a circuit like this, and if you are given any kind of an AC input signal waveform, be it sinusoidal, sawtooth, ramp, triangular, square, anything, just look at the diode position. The diode is pointing upwards. You need to clamp the entire signal above the zero baseline. So for the AC input signal, where the earlier peak value was Vm, the baseline was zero, and the negative peak was at minus Vm. For the unbiased positive diode clamper, the entire signal now shifts to the maximum peak becoming twice Vm, the baseline becoming Vm, and the negative peak now becoming zero. So here we have a tremendous DC level of plus Vm added to the AC input signal. If this particular operation of the unbiased positive diode clamper is clear to you, the remaining circuits exactly follow the same way in which the capacitor charges previously in the earlier half cycle, and it adds this voltage to the already existing AC input signal during the positive half cycle in the next phase. When we take circuit number two, you have a positively biased positive clamper. The difference which you see is that from the first case and from here, you have a DC reference voltage also added in series with the PN junction diode. Now, since this DC reference voltage is in series with the PN junction diode, it actually does not make much of a difference if you connect the battery either below the diode or above the diode, because ultimately both are in series. In the previous case, where the diode direction pointing upwards was clamping this entire signal above zero, just adding a positive DC reference voltage will clamp the signal further above the zero baseline by a value given by plus Vref. Now, this is a positive reference voltage because the negative terminal of the DC reference voltage is now connected down to ground, but the positive terminal is now connected towards the PN junction diode anode terminal. So the diode will be on, or the diode will be forward biased. The previous waveform showed you the values of plus Vm and plus 2 Vm. These values are now plus Vref. You have Vref plus Vm, and you have Vref plus twice Vm. So this particular positive bias is actually giving a further boost with a value of plus Vref to the AC input signal. Here what we see is that the entire AC input signal is clamped still deeper into a positive direction by the addition of a reference DC voltage given by plus Vref. Just as we had a positive battery reference voltage, we can also have a negative battery reference voltage. Again, the trick to understanding circuits number 2 and 3 is, since the battery is pointing upwards and the diode is also pointing upwards, the whole output signal should be shifted upwards. This plus Vref gives it a further boost as shown. Here, for this particular circuit, you have a positively sorry, you have a positive clamper but with a negatively biased reference voltage. So although the output signal will be clamped positively, this negative reference voltage will try to pull the signal slightly down below the zero baseline. Since the battery positive terminal is now connected to ground, you have a value of minus Vref, which slightly brings the signal down below the zero baseline. This is what I call as a partial clamping action. Depending upon the nature of applications, you can have a partial clamping action also in which a small portion of the AC input signal is slightly clamped below the zero baseline. So here we have the peaks changing from twice Vm to minus Vref, Vm to minus Vref, and the negative peak, which was earlier at zero, now goes down to minus Vref. And it's a very matter of fact that if you remove this value of Vref, the circuit becomes an original unbiased positive clamper in which minus Vref goes to zero, Vm minus Vref again go to Vm, and twice Vm minus Vref again goes to its original peak value of twice Vm itself. In an exactly similar way, we have an unbiased negative clamper in which the diode is now pointing downwards. You have the anode on top, you have the cathode over here below. So since the diode is now pointing downwards, the entire AC signal will be clamped negatively. I beg your pardon for these errors. This should be minus Vm and this should be minus twice Vm. So the AC input signal at the input is completely clamped into the fourth quadrant. It is clamped deep into the negative territory, in which you have the maximum peak value as zero. The DC bias level has shifted from zero to minus Vm. Sorry, should not be a plus. And the negative peak most value will be minus twice Vm. That's an unbiased negative clamper. Similar to bias clampers, we can also have a positively biased negative clamper in which you have a positive DC reference voltage connected once again in series with the PN junction diode. The negative part of the reference voltage is connected down to ground, while the positive part is connected to the cathode. Although the diode is pointing downwards, the clamping action will be negative. However, the presence of this battery voltage Vref, and in a positive way, we'll try to shift this already clamped signal slightly above zero. So we get a small peak given by the value plus Vref, protruding its head above the zero baseline. So although from the previous case, the whole signal was clamped in a negative way, here the presence of the DC reference voltage will slightly clamp the signal above the zero baseline, giving you a partial clamping action. What you see is a portion of the positive half cycle of the input signal is clamped above the ground level or the zero bias level. If we can have a positively biased negative clamper, we definitely can have a negatively biased negative clamper as well, in which the battery is now reversed. The positive part of the battery is connected to ground. The diode remains exactly as it is. So here what we see is that with the connection of a negative reference battery voltage, the output signal waveform is further clamped into the negative side in the fourth quadrant, wherein which the earlier peak signal value, which was at the zero baseline, is now given as minus Vref. The baseline, which was earlier at minus Vm, now becomes minus Vref minus Vm. This has increased in the negative direction. And the negative peak most value now becomes minus Vref minus twice Vm. So by adding a DC reference battery, you are actually able to control the amount of clamping you can have for a particular AC input signal. This is all about diode clampers: negatively biased, positively biased, negative clampers, positive clampers. Practical applications of PN junction diode clampers are to insert a DC level into an AC input signal waveform, restoring the DC level of any AC input signal waveform. It is used in analog signal conditioning techniques. It is mainly used in the transmission of TV and video signals. This is very important from the point of view of electronic communication. It is used in voltage multipliers, that is voltage doubler, voltage tripler, voltage quadrupler, etc. It is used to remove distortions in signals, particularly due to noise. It helps to protect the amplifier from large errant signals appearing at the input side. It is used to improve the overdrive recovery time in certain circuits. And finally, it is used in test and measurement equipment, radar and sonar systems. With this, we come to an end of module number one, PN junction diode and applications, during which we have covered everything right from the PN junction diode structure, its construction, its operation under forward bias condition, reverse bias condition, zero bias condition. We have also seen what is the VI characteristics of a PN junction diode. We have also looked into what is the avalanche breakdown condition. And most importantly, we have analyzed the effects of temperature variations on the PN junction diode operations. All this was covered during unit number 1.1 as given by lecture number 1. For lecture number 2, we covered unit number 1.2, in which we saw the applications of a PN junction diode as a clipper. And here we have ended unit number 1.2 by looking at the application of a PN junction diode as a clamper. Now, before we call it a day, I would just like you to think on one simple point. In diode clipper circuits, we had seen something called as a voltage transfer curve or a voltage transfer characteristic. You had the input signal plotted on the x-axis, and you had an output signal plotted on the y-axis. However, these voltage transfer characteristics are not seen in PN junction diode applications as a clamper. I just want you to slightly think into this part, that why are we not having voltage transfer curves or VTC characteristics for diode clampers? It is of course not the fact that I have not taken it, but these such curves do not exist for diode clampers. If you want a small hint, I would suggest in looking at the nature of the input and the output signal waveforms. Perhaps you are able to get a small bit of hint from that. And finally, ending with the list of textbooks still remain the same. We have Donald Neiman, Sedra, Smith, Chandorkar, Sanjeev Gupta, Santosh Gupta prescribed as the textbooks. Reference books once again are the same, Robert Boylestad and Louis Nashelsky. We have David Bell, we have Mohammad Rashid, and we have Saliv Anand as well as Suresh Kumar. The online website resources still remain the same. With this, we have successfully completed module number 1 of the subject Electronic Devices ED. I thank you very much for attending all the lectures. Once again, thanks a lot.